Wow, what a winter pattern we have been in. It's one thing to see a lot of systems across the north, but we're talking about major winter implications far south. This is Dallas, Texas from last night. Yeah, lots of the city without power as rolling blackouts are ongoing due to just the cold. They can't handle the cold. Their infrastructure's not built for it. The gauges and instruments to produce the electricity needed to heat the homes just can't handle this, so they're having to conserve power. That's a problem. Still see some snow and ice on the roadways in spots. This is even further south into Texas near the Houston area. Pipe bursts, temperatures below freezing. Inside, it's a winter wonderland in there. It's like Elsa's playground. Not good at all. These are folks that are not used to anything like this. And then you get the infrastructure that just can't handle it. And unfortunately, more winter blasts on the way. Another storm with some major winter weather impacts for Arkansas, portions of Louisiana, and Texas as well. This storm will zoom off towards the northeast and, yes, produce some significant impacts further northeast. But this is just where it's a really big deal with the freezing rain and then the snow on the north side. That could be some potent snow, too. Good news is right along the Gulf Coast, it's warm enough for rain. This system lifts northeastward, and we'll have an expanding precip shield somewhere Indiana, Michigan, Ohio, that sees a couple inches, maybe a few inches or so, but the big deal snow looks to be Ohio River Valley up into portions of southern Pennsylvania, New York City, up into portions of New England as well as the system moves northeastward once again. There's going to be some sleet and freezing rain issues closer to the coast and the southeast, looking at another squall line of thunderstorms possibly producing severe weather. So you can kind of see that widespread, lighter nature of the snow back here. Another system trying to come in from the northwest. Is it going to blow up? You'll see in a moment, but quiet, at least for a couple days, across the middle portions of the nation. So how much snow are we talking about? It's going to be a widespread corridor of about 5 to 10, maybe 6 to 12 inches or so across portions of the northeast back into the Ohio River Valley. The problem is where you have that 5 to 10 plus inches far south, Arkansas, down to the Ark-La-Tex. Not good. So watch this system start to actually shrink a little bit. No record-breaking snow events likely once we go in towards the end of the week, weekend into next week. We'll see some lake effect snow showers this weekend, but this system pulls out and a lot of the cold air is going to start to break down as well. We'll have more on that in just a little bit. There's still going to be some systems moving across, but notice more warm air, green. It's actually going to rain in Ohio. You're not going to deal with another snow system. Good news there that there's at least better chances for some warmer air and not a busy pattern across the middle of the country anymore. Not a ton coming out of the west. This is a little bit more relaxed, more normal. There's still some systems here and there, but a lot of this is going to be more tempered. It's been a busy pattern, guys. Major cold air will start breaking down as we go throughout the week into the weekend. By early next week, we're going to start replacing the colors as we go towards more like yellows and reds and some browns. That is decently above, if not well above average temperatures in spots. We'll close out February on a warmer note. But as we go into March, there will be waves of cold air coming down, replaced with some warmer, replaced with some colder, more of a typical up and down pattern, as there'll be more systems, not quite as relentless with the pattern, though, in terms of activity. As we go into the springtime, landscapers, construction, Department of Public Works, and any other industry that makes decisions based off the weather, I'd love if you come talk to us here at NeoWeather. We can help you out with specific impact-based forecasts that allow you better decisions for your operation.